Hey, I'll play just a little bit of this song. I'll teach it to you right afterwards. So has that cool riff. Let's start with the riff, okay? So the tabs are up there, they should help. And start from the fourth string. And I'm capoing on the second fret. So when there's the zero there, it means I'm just playing the open string on the fourth fret with the capo on. Zero, two. Zero, two to the third string, open. 0 2 0. Then I play the sixth and the third at the same time, then come back to two on the fourth string. So we have, then out to one on the second string, then I'm playing three on the sixth and zero on the second to the third string, open. Second fret on the fourth to third fret on the fifth, and open on the third. That's what we have so far. Then next section, starting from five relative to the capo, five, three, two on the first string. 5 3 2 zero on the first and zero on the fifth. 1 on the second. 3 on the third. 2 and 2 on the fifth and first. To 3 on the second. 0. 3 on the fifth and zero on the first. Then on the second string, 3 0 2. And then it kind of alternates, because then it comes back to the zero and zero, skipping those first three notes, that 0 2 0. So sometimes it does the 0 2 0. Those last three notes, 3 0 2, skipping those first three again, and right to the zeros and zeros. So sometimes, and then like the next time through, it would go through the whole song, and instead of playing that 3 0 2 at the end, those last three notes, it would play the first three notes the next time. 0 2 0. Good. So that's the riff. It'll take some time to get used to. This represents a couple hours of my practice already, and it's not where I want it to be yet. So riffs like this just take some extra time to kind of get down, to just kind of chord out with the song. Do you think about me when you're all alone? Chords are easy enough, so we're doing from an E minor, fifth string, fourth string. These guys are on the first and second string, third fret. They just hang out there. E minor to G, fifth string, sixth string. To C, C add 9, fifth string, fourth string, chords to the C. Then to A minor, and a good version of A minor in this pattern is taking the middle finger off. It's a version of A minor. Kind of an A minor or a G over B, where instead of putting the top on the G, I just kind of put that one on and play from the fifth string down back to C. So overall, it's E minor to G to C, A minor, G over B, C, and that just goes over and over for the whole song. You can do the whole song that. Or start from the E minor. Do you think G about me when C all along? A minor, things we use, G over B, do we use to C, B, E minor. I could be G, want to make you see, feel that way. A minor, I could be G over B, one to set you C free, and get through the whole song. Dun, 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 dun. could kind of strum it out or just kind of do one at a time. So that's the song. Super cool. Works well for a kind of a cool guitar riff. Hope it helped. Thanks for watching. See ya.